Representative Daley, you represent 4 fine school districts, public school districts in Pennsylvania. You're proud to represent them. However, you're here today to voice some concerns you have as far as funding goes from the state end. So, first talk about the dynamic of your school districts, and then we're going to get into your concerns.
My school districts are Lower Merion, Wissahickon, Colonial, and Upper Dublin. They're wonderful school districts. They're supported by the taxpayers, and they have strong local funding. They have good tax bases in all of those school districts, so they're very fortunate. And the parents and residents are very interested in public education, so it's a tremendous environment. Sure. I just would briefly say that we're next to Philadelphia, which we border on Philadelphia, and they, of course, have other issues that they deal with. And people in the district seem to be concerned about that also and recognize the disparities.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Now, you get out there and you meet the teachers, you meet the school personnel, you meet the students, so you see the faces to what this education funding is. However, you're concerned about how we get to that point, how we get to really the allotment, the quote-unquote funding formula for your school districts, for basic education, for special education, and your concern is a lack thereof of a funding formula.
That's right, Stephanie. Without a funding formula, which would be in place to consider all of the factors, I really feel like our school districts, residents and taxpayers probably put more into the local share than the average across the state. And while they may be able to do that, in the long run, I think that can hurt them. Things like special ed, mm-hmm. we find, and the schools have told me, that their special ed programs are so good that people move into the district.
Well, that's great.
For special ed, which is terrific to have that kind of a reputation, but it also puts an extra burden on the taxpayers. Mm-hmm. And so it's that kind of a thing that I think a formula would potentially help. And my understanding is there was one a few years ago, and it's been abandoned, and that we should really be taking a strong look at that.
Sure. Are you concerned that at the state level it'll be a continuation of quote-unquote passing the buck that you don't want to see happen years down the road, because you're only hurting the local economies, the local school districts, the more reliance you put on the local taxpayers to fund education?
Absolutely, and especially with the pension issues that we have. Pensions are a huge cost, and I think an appropriate cost for the school districts and the state, and it's important that we put the money into them, but that because money wasn't put in past years, they are underfunded. And so with the current funding, there's a lot going into that, and I'm sorry I'm not being more specific, but a huge portion of the state allocation is geared towards the pension reform as opposed to basic education. And so with these challenges that we see coming forward with the budget, I really feel that we need to take a serious look at how we're going to handle that.
Sure. In addition to the pension costs, are there other fixed costs that you're worried that are, say, taking too much of that state allocation, putting into the have-tos as opposed to the we should be putting it here, X, Y, Z?
Well, you know, school districts have facility costs, they have teacher contracts, they have health care costs, and you know, those are somewhat predictable until they come up on a contract year. And I never want to put the teachers as, you know, that's where we should be making the cuts, because I think our school districts are so good because we have such excellent teachers. And so I strongly support their ability to earn a living wage and be paid appropriately for the important job that they do. But I also think that we need to have some type of a formula, because I know that it becomes a burden. And with Act One and the inability to just raise taxes, you know, I don't think anyone who ever imposes taxes on their fellow residents wants to do it in a thoughtless kind of way. I think we need to be very thoughtful in how we do it, but we do have to pay for education. It's a huge investment for our children and for the future of our state and our neighborhoods and you know, how we do things.
Sure. So to sum it up, you know, the education funding is a huge issue that comes up every year around June when we're getting closer to the budget deadline. It probably takes a lion's share of budget-related topics. However, you are following this issue the whole year through. So what do you want to see happen between now and, say, the next budget cycle, the next fiscal year? You know, this is a fight that you continue to fight here in Harrisburg and at home.
I keep talking about it because I think it's such an important issue, and I want to keep it in front of us. Because I think if it fades away until the spring, then we won't be thinking about it. So I think it's important to continue to talk and use any influence that we have to work towards a formula that would end up making things more equitable and to fund education appropriately.
Okay, with us, Representative Daley, I want to thank you for your time. It's been a pleasure joining us.
Thank you so much.
If you want to follow Representative Daley, you can do so by logging on to www.pahouse.com/mdaley.